If you like this video, why not subscribe? Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of The Frugal Filmmaker, the place where we talk about making movies, whether you have money or not. Now today I want to talk about an awesome special effect which has been around ever since the advent of film, and that's slow motion. Now originally this effect was achieved by running film through the camera faster and then playing it back at a normal rate, and it would appear to have slowed down. This was called overcranking your camera. Now, you can do the same effect with current video cameras and DSLRs that allow you to shoot at 60 frames per second or 60p, 60 frames progressive, because you're having more frames than you need, and when you play it back at a normal speed, it appears to have slowed down. But what if you don't have one of these cameras? What if you have just a normal video camera? Well, if you have a camera that'll allow you to shoot at 60 frames interlaced and allow you to adjust the shutter speed, you can achieve the same effect. You just need an editor that will allow you to edit at the double NTSC frame rate, which not all editors will allow you to do. You need something that's a little more higher end, something like Final Cut Pro or Premiere Pro or Vegas Pro, which is what I'm going to use. I guess you need an editor that has Pro in the name, and then you're all set. Now this effect is a little different than what you typically get in your editor, because you can theoretically get any kind of slow motion if you slow down the footage in post-production, but it doesn't always look very good. It jitters and it's not smooth. But this effect, this trick that I'm going to show you, will give you smooth slow motion that looks great. And here's how you do it. Okay, the first thing you're going to do is download the Logarithmic lossless video codec and install it on your computer. You can find the link in the description below, and it'll take you right to this downloader. You're going to save the file and then double click on it, and it'll install directly in your computer without any further ado. It's very easy, but it's very necessary to getting the desired result. Okay, let's go ahead and set up your camera. First, you're going to adjust your frame rate to 60i or 60 interlaced frames. That should be pretty simple. Then you're going to go and adjust your shutter speed. I have to go to shutter priority mode on my Canon, and I'm going to set my shutter speed for about 1/500th. And I'm ready to shoot. All right, let's do some slow-moing. Open up Vegas Pro. This is version 8. It's currently in version 10. I've got 8. Go to your project video properties. Click on it. Then go to this little folder here in the upper right corner. This is Match Media Settings. This is going to import all your settings according to the video clip that you give it. I'm double-clicking on a video clip that I shot. It's actually the same one I'm going to slow down. Now you're going to modify this window even more. You're going to change field order to progressive scan. You're going to change full resolution rendering quality to best. And make sure your deinterlace method is interpolate fields. Then you're going to go to frame rate and change it to double NTSC. You can also save this as a preset if you want. Notice mine went to slow motion because I've already saved it. Press OK. Now drag your video clip into the timeline and adjust it to whatever it is you're going to slow down. Adjusting the front and back here. You can kind of see from the video, it looks like it's ripping a little bit because it's interlaced, so you know you've shot it properly. Right click on this and go to properties to make sure that your smart resample is turned on. That's what you want. It is. Highlight the clip, go to render as, which you can find in the file menu, or is this little icon here. And then you're going to go to save as type, video for Windows. And I've already got a preset set for this, but I'm going to go to default so I can show you what you need to change. Go to your custom button. Make sure video rendering quality is best. Go to your video tab. Make sure your frame size is the same. Your frame rate is the same. Remember, it's the double NTSC. Your field order should be none progressive scan. Your video format, you're going to want the logarithmic lossless codec that you installed. And you can also save this as a preset if you want. I've done that also, I think. Anyway, I'm not sure which one it is, so I'm just going to hit OK. And now I'm going to render. So I'm going to change the name to Walking Slow 1 and save. Okay, open up a new project in Vegas. Go to your project properties, go to your Match Media. and select your walking slow clip one that you just created. Make sure everything's in order. Progressive scan, best, interpolate fields. Notice your frame rate is correct. Hit OK. Now you're going to drag your walking slow one clip into the timeline. You're going to right click on it, go to properties, disable resample, and change the playback rate to the slow motion speed you want. I want the clip to be half speed, so I'm going to go 0.5 or 50%. Okay, now this is something I always forget to do. Your clip is now twice as long as it once was because it's only going half as fast. So drag the clip out to its full length before you render it. So there it's stretched out. Double click on it to highlight it. Go to render as. Select your video for Windows. I've got a preset set up for this, but I'm going to unpreset it. Go to the custom button. Video rendering quality is best. Go to the video tab. Make sure your frame size is correct. Your frame rate should now be switched back to 29.97, the original speed of your project. Go to video format. Change it to logarithmic lossless codec as before. Hit OK. Come up with a clever name like walking slow final or done. Oops. And hit save. Okay, now all you have to do is drag that clip into your normal speed timeline and you're all set. Now I have to give credit where credit is due. This is not my original idea. I came across this a couple years ago on the excellent blog called Eugenia's Rants and Thoughts. She's a filmmaker that uses Sony Vegas Pro on a lot of things, and there's a lot of good advice there, a lot of great tips. So check it out. Her original post was called Butter Smooth Slow Motion. You can find a link to it in the description. Now before all of you get up in my face and say, Scott, your show's called The Frugal Filmmaker, but you're recommending that I get a $500 editor? Are you out of your mind? Well, it's unfortunate that the less expensive editors don't allow you to shoot in, or edit in double NTSC, but that unfortunately is the case. The good news is you can download a free trial of Sony Vegas Pro 10. Check the link below. It's an uncrippled version. It'll last for 30 days. You can try this effect out for yourself. If you like this tip, please come to thefrugalfilmmaker.com for more, and you can find us at all the typical places. We'll see you next time. Bye.